Metformin. I see patients on this on a daily basis, but in today's episode, we're going to talk about how to start taking metformin to reduce its possible side effects. Now, let me know how you're getting on by leaving a comment at the end of the video. First, a bit of background about metformin. It's prescribed to treat type 2 diabetes and polycystic ovary syndrome, which we call PCOS. Metformin lowers your sugar levels by reducing the amount of sugar that your liver releases into your blood and also improving your body's response to insulin. Now, it's usually prescribed in type 2 diabetes when diet and exercise alone hasn't been enough to reduce your blood sugar levels. For women with PCOS, metformin stimulates ovulation even if you don't have diabetes, and it does this by lowering blood sugar levels and lowering insulin. Background done. I've always found metformin to be a very interesting drug because not only does it help with PCOS and lower blood sugar levels, but studies have actually shown it to reduce your risk of cancer and help you lose weight. Unfortunately, metformin can cause side effects in some patients like nausea, wind, and diarrhea. But the chances of developing these can be reduced by taking it after food, and also when you first started on them, building up your dose slowly to the prescribed dose. Now, you've just been started on immediate release metformin, and hopefully your prescriber will explain to you how to slowly build up your dose to the prescribed dose. And this is to help reduce the chances of you developing side effects. And in the world of pharmacy, this building up, we call it dose titrating. Now, in case they haven't or you've just forgotten, here's a general guide on how to build up your dose of immediate release metformin to the prescribed dose. Now, please remember, this is a general guide, and your dose may be different, so I definitely advise everyone to speak to their doctor or speak to your pharmacist about this. So in this example, let's say the final dose of immediate release metformin for type 2 diabetes was 3 times a day with main meals. So we have breakfast, lunch, and dinner, which you'll be taking it with. But we don't want to jump straight into 3 times a day, as you're much more likely to have side effects, which we mentioned earlier. So build up your dose weekly to the final prescribed dose. So for my example, to begin with, take 500 milligrams of immediate release metformin daily with your biggest meal, which is dinner for most people. After a week or two, if you're getting on fine with no significant side effects, increase to 500 milligrams twice a day with main meals. So for most people, that would be breakfast and dinner. And after another week or two, if you're getting on fine with no significant side effects, increase to 500 milligrams 3 times a day with main meals, so breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Please remember, this is a general guide and your dose may be different, so always speak to your pharmacist or doctor about this before you do it. So what we're basically doing is building up the dose of immediate release metformin by 500 milligrams every 1 to 2 weeks until we reach the final dose prescribed by your doctor. And if after a dose increase you start getting side effects which don't go after a week or two, then reduce the dose back down to what you were getting on well with. Then speak to your doctor. Definitely don't stop taking your medicines until you speak to your doctor. Now, let's say after slowly building up your dose of immediate release metformin, you're still having side effects and it's getting too much. Well, now it's time to speak to your doctor about it. They might change your medicine completely, or they might change the type of metformin and give you the slow release tablet, which usually has less side effects. But remember this, that the dose of the slow release tablet is different to the immediate release tablet. So always double check it with your pharmacist or doctor. And that's it. You now know how to start taking immediate release metformin properly. If you have any tips which work for you, which others might find helpful, then please leave a comment below. I'd love to read about it. And if you found this video helpful, then please hit that like button now. Lastly, don't forget to always read the information leaflet that comes with your medicines. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask your pharmacist. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.